Hey, what's up YouTube? Leo Shane here, host of the Extreme Philly Fishing Channel. Here you guys can have a nice view of me on the mirror. So I'm here in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. I finally made it, you know? Whew, took the airplane this afternoon, 5:50 p.m. Got here around 9:30 p.m. I'm here on my in my hotel room right now. Let me show you guys outside, actually. Fort Lauderdale, yeah. There we go, huh? View is pretty different. Yeah, you see? Cool trees and everything. There's a little pool here at the hotel. Anyways, have a little nice view of this place. I don't wanna yell out there because it's like 10 p.m., you know, and some people are sleeping already. But anyways, so I'm here in Florida. As I told you guys, I would be spending here, be spending 4 days down here for some fishing, right? I mean, of course, my main job, my main goal, right, was to come down here to for a job offer. But of course, I'm gonna sneak out and do some fishing as well, right? And you know, you guys may be wondering, right, what is inside my fishing pack, right? I mean, some folks, some subscribers have been asking me, you know, to do a little video on what is exactly inside my fishing bag. So I just decided to do that, you know. So yeah, let me show you guys what I brought down here to Florida. Here, sit down with me. All right, let's take it easy. Before we start, funny story, you know, I brought this bag pretty much for fishing, right? So everything that I need for my fishing for this next 2 days is inside this bag, salt water and fresh water, right? The funny story is, you know, when you go to the airport, you have to pass the TSA security, right? And, you know, when you pass the TSA security, you have to pass your bag, and they can see exactly what is inside your bag, right? How many things, where, and what, right? They have the little X-ray monitor kind of thing. And it was funny because when I passed my bag, as you guys will see soon, the TSA lady was like, oh my God. And I, you know, and I looked at her face and she looked at me and I knew immediately that it was my bag, right? And usually what they do, they just scan the bag, right? So the bag goes like, zzz, you know, passes and it's done. For my bag, she went back and forth like 3 times because there was just so much junk in the bag, you know, that she was like surprised. You know, that's the funny story. You know, after I got past the security, the lady was like, there's gotta be at least 200 hooks in your bag, but I'm just gonna let you go because I know you gotta go fishing and stuff, you know? So it was a nice lady. So TSA lady, if you're watching this, thank you very much for not confiscating my hooks, okay? Because if you did, I would have to buy new ones down here and that would be a mess. All right, so anyways, let me quickly show you guys here what is inside my bag. Try to make this as brief as possible because, you know, even though it's nighttime, I may still go out to do some fishing. Okay, let's start over here. So let's unpack everything. I'm gonna show you guys what exactly is inside my bag for fishing, okay? There you go, juicy fruit, all right? Gotta have some bubble gum, especially after you eat a garlic. You never know, right? Scissors, very important for fishing. Right, always. Pack of floats, all right? This, I'm gonna leave over here for now because I'm gonna go over that in detail. That's important. Let's see what else is inside here. Band-aids, all right? Oops, this one even fell out, all right? But band-aids, all right? First aid, you never know when you're gonna get hurt. Pain reliever from Walgreens, okay? You never know when you're gonna get a headache. All right, there we go. We got here, 2 packs of flies, assorted flies, okay? So let me just open here real quick, give you guys a look, all right? Different types of flies, assorted. Your Wally right over there, very niche. Second box right here, also assorted, but smaller sizes, a smaller hook, yeah. You never know when you're gonna use it, right? I come down here to Florida. As a matter of fact, I always carry these flies with me. It doesn't matter where I go, okay? Let's see what else is inside here. Nail clipper, right? Always need a nail clipper. What else? Pliers, right? To unhook the fish. All right, those are really like the necessaries. All right, pack of sinkers, different sizes and different types. All right, this I'm gonna leave together with the floats, because because I'm going to go a little bit more detail. So that's it for this portion of the bag. Let's go a little bit up here now. All right. Fishing licenses. All right. Two of them, PA and New Jersey. GoPro case for rain, just in case. GoPro batteries. All right. I have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 plus the one on the GoPro right now. So like 10 batteries total. All right. And each battery lasts about 1.5 hours. So that's like a total of 15 hours. Okay, we got a microchip. Whoa, what happened to the microchip that is supposed to be on top of this? Uh-oh. Anyways, it's somewhere inside here. There's supposed to be a microchip, you know, on top of this. Let me see, what is it? A lot of quarters, because you never know when you go out. You never know when you're gonna need quarters. So I have a lot of quarters in my bag. Man, I'm concerned now. What happened to my little microchip there? Did I not bring it with me? Uh-oh. Okay, so I may have forgotten my extra microchip, which is a problem, okay? Ouch. So let me see, is it really not here? Yep. Oh, all right. So yeah, I forgot my microchip apparently. Let me see if it's inside the battery pack. You know, sometimes I put inside the battery pack. Nope, it is not. All right, so I have a limited amount of videos to film on my GoPro, all right? Oh boy, I should have brought an extra one. I may buy one if I need down here, you know. Over here in this compartment, my Nintendo 3DS, always keeping me company. Chargers for everything, very important. Charger for the GoPro batteries, all right? 15 hours may not be enough, right? My camera, the one that you guys always see, right, me using. For good quality photos, and that's pretty much it. Now for the main compartment, there are my clothes all the way down. Oh boy. Okay, let's go back by bag. We got here the bag with hooks, split shots, snap swivels. All right, there is at least 300 hooks in this bag. Okay, jig heads, everything else. I gotta go through that. Then there is this bag here, full of lures. All right, that's another bag right there. Three fishing reels, Shimano Sedona 4000 FD, Daiwa Samurai, and my Symmetry 4000 FL. All right, this is pretty much it for my bag. On my Oakley sunglasses, right, and a book, of course. Everyone needs the sport fish of Florida, right, to identify the different species, right? Very informative book with photos, scientific name, description, size, food value, game quality, tackle and bait, fishing system, blah blah blah. Yeah, all different types. Yeah, check that out. Yeah, all right, we definitely gotta catch some fish down here. As for fishing rods, let me show you guys real quick here. I got my fishing case over here, plano, right, that I carried on the plane. I have brought two fishing rods with me. All right, let me take it out. Never bring just one for your trips because you never know what's gonna happen, right? So I brought my Daiwa Samurai, that is like my heavy action, and I brought my St. Croix Avid Pearl, that is like my medium light, okay? Since I'm gonna be doing saltwater and freshwater fishing. So two rods for three reels, okay? Shimano Symmetry 4000 FL, I just spooled with 8 pounds Berkeley Vanish fluorocarbon. It's filled to the top, all right, just in case. My Sedona 4000, it is with 15 pounds braided line, Castmaster, pink, you know, very neat stuff. My Daiwa is just with the Power Pro 50 pounds, the old one that I've been using for a while. You know, this never goes bad, right? Now, let's just quickly go through the bags, you know, because I really need to go fishing, you know, but since you guys wanted to see what's inside my bag, I just can go over a little bit detail, right? All right, so we got a pack of floats, different sizes, weighted floats, okay? I plan on using live minnows, live shiners, actually, for fresh water that I'm going to buy at the tackle shop, you know? So if I do that, definitely we'll need some floats, right, to let them stay there. Sinkers, different sizes, different types. 1 ounce to 3 ounces, you have here egg sinkers, river sinkers, trolling sinkers, pyramid, there should be a pyramid over here for different types of situations, okay? but I bought a three. I brought a 3 ounces max. If the current is faster than that, it doesn't matter where I go, I'll just buy it at the local tackle shop. When it comes to the hooks, all right? Oh my God, let's go one by one then. Mustad hooks, size 10, 100 pieces. All right, it's a little bit of an exaggeration, but you never know when you're gonna use it, right? Size 6, 100 pieces, all right? Size H, 100 pieces. So that's already 300 pieces right there. Split shot box, different sizes, okay? Easy to remove, easy to put on. You never know when you're gonna use it. I got the bonehead tackle, jig heads, two of them left that came on my mystery tackle box for October, you know, pinfish. I thought it was pretty cool to use them, so I brought them along, all right? I got here some jig heads. This one are probably 3/8 of an ounce or maybe half. No, these are 3/8 of an ounce for the zoom flukes. I have zoom flukes in the other pack there. All right, small octopus hooks, size 6 gamakatsu for soft plastics. Size 1/0 hooks, eagle claw. All right, so as you guys can see, a different variety for different types of fish. Size 6 hooks, and there are also two hooks here that I did it myself. They are for carp, just in case I go carping down here. Chances are I'm not going to do carping, but just in case, I did two hair rigs with pink line. We got here three-way swivels. This is not the original pack, as you guys can see, okay? But three-way swivels, very fundamental, necessary for me. Snap swivels, barrel swivel, golden collar, eagle claw. Trout magnet, jig head, 164 ounce, all right, for smaller types of fish. I got gold minnows in my other bag too. Football jig heads, all right. I don't know what size are these, but I definitely gonna use this with zoom flukes on the surf or something like that. Another bag of split shots, a little bit bigger. And finally, packs of hooks already snelled, all right? So I got here size 6 hooks. I got here, I'm sorry, not size 6. This is size 2 hooks. Size 2 hooks. I got here premium snail fish hooks with leader for saltwater. I got all-purpose bottom fishing hook, size 6, also for surf fishing, all right? So this is my pack for hooks, swivels, all right? Now I got this one here with lures, all right? The original plan down here is actually to use live bait, live shiners, night crawlers, shrimp, squid, anything live, because I want to catch as many species as possible. However, if I run out of live bait or something happens, I have to have something to back me up, right? So these are the things that I brought with me, okay? Fish bites, as you guys know, bloodworm scented, very nice for smaller types of fish. Two Thomas inline spinners, always carry these with me. One Thomas lures buoyant, this is a little spoon, very, very nice also. A boy, a pet crusher. I don't really know how this thing passed the TSA because it's got really big hooks, but I guess the lady was really nice to me, you know. These two big hooks, you know, Storm, three pack, I mixed and matched different colors, all right. Two packs of trout magnets, one green resembling a caterpillar, one yellow resembling a waxworm. You never know what fish around here will eat, right? So, two small micro chatterbaits from Z-Man, all right? Chatterbaits, a lot of noise, a lot of vibration, chartreuse white, all right? And finally, my favorite, right? A whole container of a 1-inch gulp alive minnow, but I removed the liquid, right? Because you cannot take the liquid with you on the plane by TSA regulations. Anything flammable, you can't really take it with you, right? So that's pretty much it. There is another bag here, if I'm not wrong. Yep, see, there was another bag. Just a bag full of soft plastics that I packed at home, all right? I'm not gonna open this thing up, but pretty much got some bonehead tackle, slim sticks, zoom flukes, these are the baby ones, these are the regular ones. Senkos, 3-inch, 4 inches, cream lures, night crawler, and then just a variety of different types of little plastics that resemble fish, okay? I think there are two grubs inside too, as you guys can see, one right here, all right? I can put it behind a jig head and just, you know, reel it in, right? So there you go. This is pretty much everything that I brought down here to Florida. Besides that, you know, there's just shoes and clothes inside my bag, right? So there you go, man. This is the pack that I brought down here to catch different species of fish. Now I'm just going to organize the stuff. I'm going to do 1 day freshwater C14 canal, and I'm going to do 1 day saltwater on the surf on the pier, actually, see if we can catch anything. All right, fellas, so this is, now you know, this is what Leo carries inside his his bag, okay? This is what I consider to be essential for multi-species fishing, catching a huge variety of different types of fish. Now we just need to see how successful I will be with all these things, right, that are available to me. I'll keep you guys updated. Videos will be on my YouTube channel, all right? Timelines, thumbs up. Fish on. Woohoo! Yeah! Finally, new species. I think... Oh man, what is that? Whoa, no, 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 no way, you're getting away, buddy. No, 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 no. Whoa, whoa! Alright, this fish can jump. This fish can jump. That's dangerous, man. Oof. God damn. Alright, new species for me. Some kind of needlefish, maybe an Atlantic needlefish, I would say so. Yeah, really neat little fella. Ooh, lively. Man, look at those. Look at this teeth, huh? This is no joke. That's why this guy's going after minnow. Whew. Let's take a photo of this guy. New species for my species list. Gotta take a photo and then release it. Very long. Right, let's take a photo of the mouth of this beast. Wow. Gotta tell you, folks, any fish out of Florida is a good fish. Because I don't have any of them. So for me, you know, the multi-species, it goes well. All right, let's take a photo for the Instagram. There we go. All right, good to go, my little friend. Yeah, ready to go. That's what's going on, huh? Mosquitoes.
I need to buy some bug spray.
I agree with that. Fish on. What we got here? Man, I did not come this far. 2.5 hours by plane. Puffer fish. Now, what type of puffer fish is this? Yeah, for sure this is a puffer fish, all right? I just don't know what type yet. Is this a northern puffer? Oh, look at that, look at that. Oh, puffer fish. Come on, give me a break. I'm not gonna hurt you, all right? It's all right, buddy. It's all right, okay. You know what? Let's take a photo of this puffer fish and just release it. Oh, shall we? I have caught a northern puffer in New Jersey. Hopefully this is a new species of puffer for me. Yeah, let me catch the whole body. Gotta take a couple additional photos for this little fellas. Yeah, beautiful. Of all different types of fish that I, you know, I would be able to catch here, a puffer. Okay, let's go, let's go. Let me unhook you real quick here, buddy, so you can go back where you belong to, shall we? And they got strong teeth, so you don't want to mess with that. You see that? You see the little teeth here? They got strong, strong teeth. You definitely don't want to mess with that. All right. Hopefully that's a new species. I don't know. I need to double check, actually. Whew, mosquitoes everywhere. All right, fish on. Whatever this is, it's new for me. So that's good. It's some kind of jack, I think, from the body, from the shape of the body. So that's like 30 species. Just gotta be careful. Make sure this guy doesn't have anything on the dorsal fins. I'm not too familiar with the species around here. You see, whoa, there, see? There are two spikes down here already that you definitely don't want to touch, or else you wanna get, you gotta get hurt. This is definitely from the jack family. Whew, I just don't know what it is yet. Yellow tail, black markings. Yeah, let me take a couple photos. Clear view photos, so I can actually identify this fish later. Yeah, two spikes down there. Black pectoral fin. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Very small in size, but very, very vicious. Attacked my gold minnow like it was nothing. Yeah, gotta be very careful with the spines on its body. Whew, boy. So this is what I'm using right now, folks. Let me give a set of, an overview of it. It's no different than what I use in Philadelphia, really. I'm using a 164 ounce trout magnet jig head with a little gold minnow. 1 inch alive, you know. And on my otter rod, the one that I caught the puffer fish on, I'm actually using the fake bloodworm, right? The ones that you guys are already well familiar with. So the one that dissolves in the water after you put on. So yeah, man, that was beautiful, you know. That that jack there, whatever one was, you know, beautiful, beautiful. Third different species for the day if you count the little puffer. So there we go, yeah, little gold minnow on a 164 ounce jig, weightless, no weight, just drop it in and see what hits. Fish on. Yeah. Beautiful puffer. Bigger than the last one too. So this one deserves a photo. Yeah, wow, way bigger than the last one. Come on, don't poof yourself. Don't poof yourself. No. Stop. Stop the poofing process. Oh my God. Why this fish gotta be so hard, man? Don't mess with me, puffer. All right, quick photo. Hopefully, like I mentioned, a new species of puffer for me. This is the second one that I caught here. There seems to be a good population of puffer fish here in this place that I'm fishing at. And by the way, this place that I'm fishing at, see, look at the teeth of this puffer fish. I don't know how well you guys can see it, you know? Look at the teeth of this creature. Gotta be very careful with that. You do not want to put your finger there. Yeah? Whew. So yeah, this place that I'm fishing is pretty much behind the surf. If you just keep walking that way, that's like the surf. There's like a couple blocks of houses and then you have it over here, right? I guess you could call it a little saltwater canal. So yeah, a couple puffer fish, that Atlantic needlefish, a little jack. No, not bad, not bad. True new species. We'll see how it goes. So yeah, folks, puffer fish, very powerful. Yeah, look, yeah, make into a ball again, huh? Yeah, chillax. Look at this, huh? Look at this, that's why I said you don't want to mess with this teeth. Check that out, look at this teeth right here. You see this? Most people don't think about it, right? Puffer fish, yeah, look at this. Man, truly shell crackers, all right? To be able to hit my fish imitation like this. All right, let me release this little fella. Come on, dang flake fish.
If you keep turning yourself into a ball, then I'm gonna have a hard time with you.
Yeah?
Look at that.
Goodness. Wow. Look at the damage. Wow. Look at this. It's like it chomped, like I would chomp my spaghetti. Wow, man.
What's up, YouTube? So, thanks for watching the first part of my trip down to Fort Lauderdale. As you guys saw in the video, this is really how I started my trip down there, right? I arrived on Monday night, the 26th, around 9:30 p.m. at my hotel. And by the way, I stayed at this wonderful place called the Shore Haven Inn. You guys can Google it. It's like 2 blocks away from shore. So it's like very, very convenient in terms of fishing. Not to mention that the rates per room are not really bad. You know, they're pretty cheap considering the price. So yeah, you know, that's how I started. I went to my hotel. It was already nighttime. I started unpacking my stuff, right? Getting ready for my job interview the next morning. And I thought it would be really cool, you know, to unpack my bag, right? And show folks what really is inside of it, right? So folks can have an idea of how exactly I prepared for a long trip, right? Because, you know, when you go somewhere far away and you have to take a plane, there are a couple things you have to take in consideration, you know, before packing your stuff. One thing, you need to know the rules and regulations. You need to know what you can carry on the plane and what you can't. You know, those are the, like, the TSA regulations, right? Making sure you are not carrying dangerous things on the plane. So, sharp knives I had to take out. Yes, my pliers, I had to bring my smallest pliers so they wouldn't take that as a weapon. The gold minnow, as you guys saw, I had to take the liquid out. If the liquid was in, they would have to check my bag and so on, you know. So that's like a nice idea for you guys to see, you know, how you prepare for a trip, especially a multi-species trip, okay? If I were just like a bass angler, like the other folks on YouTube, it wouldn't be that hard, you know, to prepare for it. Pack it in and go. But I need to think about the multi-species. What am I going to catch? I have no idea. Is it small? Is it big? I have to take the size in consideration. That's why you guys saw there were sizes, small hooks and big hooks, right? There were different types of lures. There were different types of everything, even sinkers and floats. You have to be able to adapt over there. So, you know, I thought that was really fun. But anyways, let's get started with this identification guide. As you guys saw in the video, I had absolutely no idea what types of fish those were. There are three species portrayed in this video, okay? The first one portrayed was a houndfish. The second one portrayed, and actually there are three of them in the whole video, I believe, was a checkered puffer. And the third one was a Crevalle Jack. Okay, so let's start with the first one, the houndfish. Let's take a look at its photo. Here is our houndfish, Tilosaurus crocodilus. A lot of people tend to believe, when they look at the photo of the houndfish, that this is actually an Atlantic needlefish. But please, keep in mind, there are two different species of fish, okay? As mentioned, the houndfish is the Tilosaurus crocodilus, and an Atlantic needlefish would be the Strongylura marina, okay? And you can see, actually, it is very hard to differentiate them, but you can actually see, you know, the differences over here, right? First thing, and the thing that gives it away that this is a houndfish, is its tail, okay? When you look at its tail, it is not symmetrical. An Atlantic needlefish will always have a symmetrical tail, while the houndfish has its dorsal side of the tail on the shorter side, okay? Another thing that helps us differentiate between these two species is actually to notice that very, very close to its caudal fin, there is a horizontal gray line marking, okay? So that the Atlantic fish definitely does not have, all right? So yeah, this first species was a little bit hard to identify, you know, I in the video, right, as you guys saw, I mentioned, like, this is an Atlantic needlefish. I went back to the hotel, took a look at the book, Googled some photos, with the help some other guys on Instagram, I came to the conclusion that that was actually indeed a houndfish. Okay, now let's take a look at the photos of our second species here, the checkered puffer. So here we have the checkered puffer is Phoeroides testudineus. Okay, another species that was very, very hard to identify. According to my book on fishes of southern Florida, there were three different species of puffer over there. Okay, the first one being the southern puffer is Phoeroides nephilus. The second one being the band tail puffer is Phoeroides spengleri. And the third one being the checkered puffer is Phoeroides testudineus. Okay, and the first, and I mean the main component to differentiate these three different types of puffers is actually the markings on their bodies. Okay, it is very hard to differentiate a puffer by its belly or its mouth, because all of them has this pretty much the same belly and the same mouth and the same teeth. Okay, so you gotta go by the colors. Looking in this photo, you can see that the markings on this fish, they are kind of leopard like on top, right? And that is actually a key characteristic for the checkered puffer. Below the leopard like markings, you can see a couple smaller circular dots, okay, which matches perfectly with the checkered puffer. Let's take a look at the second photo of another checkered puffer, this time an unpuffed checkered puffer. Okay, so here we go, we have the same markings that I was describing to you guys, leopard like on top, smaller circular dots below. That's how you know that is a checkered puffer, is Phoeroides testudineus. Okay, and finally the third fish portrayed in this video was a jack. Okay, it was a Crevalle Jack. Let's take a look at it. So here you have the Crevalle Jack carunx hippos. Okay, and seriously, you guys probably saw photos of big Crevalle Jack on the internet, so you guys should know already how it looks like, right? I had a slightly idea that that was a Crevalle Jack when I actually hooked it, okay? But anyways, you can see that it is one by looking first at its gill cover, the opercular flap. You can see there is a black spot there. That's the first thing that we need to watch out for. Second thing, The tail of the fish is kind of like a cycle-shaped tail, right? With yellow color on it, on the caudal fin. Not to mention, this fish also has yellow coloration on its belly, which unfortunately you can't see because of my hand, and its anal fin, okay? So the yellow coloration plus the black dot, compressed body, okay, blunt head, gives out right away. This is a Crevalle Jack, okay? So for this video, there were only three species of fish, okay? For my Florida 2 trip, I actually caught 30 different species of fish, so expect more videos to be up, okay? Although, from those 30 species, I didn't record all of them on video, okay? Because a lot of them were actually caught at nighttime. At nighttime, my GoPro, it really sucked, okay, for filming, so I didn't film those. But don't worry about it, in the next couple videos, the fishes that I caught at nighttime, I will do a proper identification guide for them, so you guys know actually what fish is that, how I caught it, and how I was able to identify it, okay? Next video should be in the YouTube channel in a couple days, so for now you guys will have to be happy with this video, okay? All videos from my Florida trip will have identification guides at the back of it. That's because, unfortunately, at the time, I didn't have the necessary knowledge, you know, to give you guys a lot about the fish, right? I mean, it was my first time seeing those fish. So what could I say, you know? I was like, I'm not sure what this is for almost every one of them, okay? And again, thank you very much for watching, you know, thank you very much for tuning in. Tie lines, until next video.
Let's see now, because I don't see that school anymore, but I will cast in there anyway. What the heck? Watch. Suddenly I look to the side, there's like some kind of chicken or something here.